Hey everybody, hope you're all doing well. My name is Steven, and this is the Storytime Channel. Today we have some I Don't Work Here Lady stories, and our first story of the day is by L'Oreal Kari, Kids Sick at Self-Checkout. Quick note, I am merely the witness in this short story. About 14 years ago now, I was working at my local Walmart, put in charge of watching the self-checkout on a slow day. I will admit that back then I was inexperienced with people and lazy, but my few months there had taught me a lot about how nasty folks can get. Good mom comes rushing to the self-checkout with sick kid in her cart. He does not look well, and I hear him saying as they come up, "I don't feel good, mom, I want to go home." Good mother clearly understands that her kid has become sicker since they came in and is trying to rush to get him home now. She is trying to soothe him while simultaneously fumbling with groceries and bare essentials like soup and boxes of tissues. "I know, sweetie, I'm sorry, mommy is going as fast as she can." Well, along comes rich man. He has on what has to be the most expensive jacket I have ever seen. Full business, gold watch, tie, pricey shoes, perfect haircut, fit, carrying a lot of coffee. Everything about him makes me glad this is self-checkout, because my track record with rich folk treating me bad here is almost 100%. He begins checking out directly across from good mother and sick kid, his back facing them. Suddenly, sick kid starts to squirm and look around wildly. "Mom, mom, mom, I need the restroom." Good mother looks up from the checkout and sees sick kid is not going to make it through her checkout. She practically flies around the cart, picks him up, and he projectile vomits across the self-checkout all over rich man's expensive jacket. My jaw drops. It can't be real. As I begin to react, I am watching rich man. He drops his coffee and is stunned for a moment when something I was not ready for happens. He turns around, quickly removing the jacket, dumps it on the floor, and walks quickly over to good mother and sick kid, kneeling, because they are now on the ground. Good mother comforting her crying child with her eyes practically begging for mercy at this point. Rich man says, "Is he okay?" I walk up with towels, already on the radio for cleanup, and hand him one. He uses it to help clean up good mother. Good mother says, "He might have the stomach flu. I just needed to pick up some things to take care of him. I'm so sorry." Rich man says, "It's okay, let's get him cleaned up." Good mother seems to finally really see the man and how he is dressed for the first time and what happened to him. She says, "Oh my god, do you work here?" Rich man wiping vomit off his back while I start on the floor. "No ma'am, just a dad myself. Hate to see a kid not feeling well." Good mother was so embarrassed that she didn't really speak again, other than a meager thank you as we finished cleaning up and rich man helped her finish checking out personally. I helped him put his certainly ruined jacket in a garbage bag to take home, and he checked out as well. I asked him if there was anything else I could do for him, and rich man politely declined and left the store. I will never forget how that man reacted that day. For all his obvious wealth, he was his last priority at that moment, even as a victim himself. He didn't complain about the mess, or that he might get the kid's flu, or his ruined jacket. Nothing. And he certainly did more to help me, the actual employee. I took this lesson to heart for all future interactions with people, and it has made a tremendous difference as I became a father myself. Thanks for reading. So let's be honest, people. Let's pretend that there isn't a pandemic going on. If you were at the self-checkout and a person's sick kid threw up on you, would you try and help the sick kid where you could? Or would you get angry, or would you just ditch? Let me know in the comments down below. Our next story is by Random Jottings, the "I don't work here" that broke my heart. I don't know if this story belongs here. It is an "I don't work here" lady story of sorts, but if you don't think it belongs, I understand if you wish to delete it. It all happened many years ago. We're talking mid to late 80s, and it's not a typical "I don't hear" story. There's no exploding Karen or any instant karma. Before I begin, I should just say that as a child, I was very close to my grandmother. Both my parents worked, and when I got out of primary school, I went to my grandparents' house until my mother picked me up. I also stayed with my grandparents during the school holidays. My grandmother taught me the basics of cooking, gave me a love of literature, and showed me the joy to be had from music. In about 1983, my grandparents emigrated to New Zealand to live near their son. My mother, their daughter, sadly died in 1981, And I was well settled in secondary school by then, so they felt making a move like that would be good for them. It was tough saying goodbye to my grandparents. I was very close to both of them, but especially my grandmother. Some years later, 1988 or thereabouts, I had started university. Just before the end of my first year, my grandparents came back to the UK for a visit. They were staying with my dad. Although he wasn't their son, he thought of them as his parents. Before Dad knew about their proposed visit, he had decided to have some work done to his house. He wanted double glazing installed and some work on the roof done. So when they arrived, there was a lot of activity going on around the house. About a week after my grandparents arrived back, my college broke up for the summer vacation and I traveled back home. I was excited to see Dad, but I was really excited to see my grandparents again. It had been a few years since I last saw them. We'd exchanged letters, but not seen each other since saying goodbye at the airport when they left for New Zealand. I got a taxi from the railway station to my dad's house, and the first thing I saw when I got home was the building site that was the front of his house, complete with builders. I didn't even need to open the front door. There wasn't one. It was being replaced. I left my backpack in the hall and went into the kitchen. My grandmother always liked being in the kitchen. The kitchen was her domain and was the place she felt most at home. The kitchen was also at the back of the house and was the farthest away from all of the work at the front of the house. So I went straight there. I opened the kitchen door and just stood there, smiling at my lovely, gentle, kind grandmother. She had aged so much but was still unmistakably my grandmother. My smile slowly disintegrated when I saw the reaction on her face. It was a look of fear and anger. Then she grabbed my grandfather's hand and said, "He's coming in. Why is he coming in? Who does he think he is? Get out!" My grandmother, who I had seen every day of my life for the first 15 years of my life, who I loved so much, didn't even know who I was. She thought I was one of the builders and was terrified of me. The fear on her face broke me, ripped my heart in two. That was both the very first I don't work here stories and also how I discovered my brilliant and loving grandmother was suffering from dementia. Firstly, my condolences to OP. Screw dementia. It's definitely a thing I wish on nobody regardless of who they are. And all I can really say is thank you to OP for being so willing to share such a story with us. Our next story is by Tess Dubois. "I'm so sorry, I'm just leaving. I'm a dowdy, frumpy, middle-aged white lady living in a slightly dodgy area of the city. I never minded taking my two dogs for a walk in the dark, but did choose to wear a high-vis coat, which makes me even chunkier, so I could be easily seen by traffic on the busy road I need to walk down. One night in winter, I was on my way to the dog field and was walking past the demolished site of a pub that had been closed down due to an incident where a policewoman had been stabbed. Spotting a car pulled up on the pavement and a man in the shadows next to the chain link fence, I paused, not sure on how to proceed. Should I try to walk past, cross the busy road, or wait and see if he left anytime soon? The dog sensed my hesitation and began to get a little anxious themselves. Berating myself for being overcautious, I returned walking slowly towards him when he turned and saw me coming.
I'm sorry, I'm sorry, I'm just going.
Okay.
I'm sorry, I know I'm not supposed to stop here, I just...
Me, now assuming that he was relieving himself. Okay.
I'm so sorry, I'm going now, I didn't realize.
Me, trying to calm down the dogs who were getting suspicious. Okay.
See, I'm going now.
Looking down at dogs.
You don't need to... Are you security here? I didn't know...
Me, light bulb moment, high-vis jacket. No, I'm just walking my dogs.
Okay, right, well, I'm just leaving.
He jumped into his car and drove off, leaving me slightly bemused and wondering what he had been up to. As I drew level to where he had been, I checked the fence. No problems. When I got home, I was telling my hubby about the encounter and wondering how he could have possibly thought little old me was security, and who was more afraid of who. My hubby dissolved into laughter and said, "Definitely the man," and doubling over with tears in his eyes, praised our two dogs. Oh, did I mention that they are two big German Shepherd dogs who come up to my waist? Hey, I don't care who it is. Two big German Shepherds is a great deterrent. Our next story is by 4Fun Woodworker. Not my job to clean your patient. This was a few years ago, but it is still very satisfying thinking about it. Backstory. I was a 24-year-old guy working as a mental health technician at a county hospital in Arizona. I was specifically trained and certified to do work with teens, youth, adults, and elderly who were a danger to themselves or others. This included those that were brought in by the police for being violent and needed one-on-one supervision 24 hours a day. It's generally very boring and easy because the patient is sedated and strapped to the bed. This story is about one of these guys. A patient had been brought into the ER by the police for whatever reason and had been extremely dangerous and violent with the police and hospital staff. I had been requested to go to their wing of the hospital. We normally only work in the mental health ward and monitor and restrain if needed for the hospital staff. I was stilling in the corner of his room on my phone, probably playing games, when a nurse came in to check on him. The conversation went something like this. The nurse says, "I'm going to need you to do something more than sitting there in the corner on your phone." I say, "Excuse me? I need you to clean him and empty his urine bag."
"Nope, I'm not trained to do that."
"Listen, I don't have time to deal with this. You're going to do this or I'm going to get the doctor."
"Do you see CNA? Certified Nurse's Aide. On my badge anywhere?" It says MHT, Mental Health Tech. I am not certified to do a CNA's job. If I did clean him and change his urine bag but did something wrong, it would be your job and not mine. "Go ahead. You can get the doctor and ask him yourself."
"You have no right to tell me what your job is. I will have your job for this."
She storms out of the room and looks for the doctor. After a few minutes, I can hear her voice just outside the room. I just go to the doorway. I'm still able to see my patient, to hear her, and see the doctor. Nurse to the doctor,
he,
pointing at me,
is telling me that he won't do what I asked him just because he isn't a CNA.
Me to the doctor,
she is telling me I have to clean him and change his urine bag, but I have told her that it would be her job if I did something wrong.
Doctor to the nurse, he's right. He has no responsibility, nor is he certified to do it. He is supposed to sit with him and watch him to keep you safe. Do your job and stop trying to find someone to do your job. It turns out there was no CNA for her area that night. She was trying to push her work off on other people, and I was her last attempt until the doctor lost his patience. If my job description does not include cleaning patients and emptying their urine bags, you're not gonna get me to do it anytime soon. So I don't blame OP for standing their ground on this one for sure. Our next story is by Superb Alternator. Wearing yellow was a grave mistake. So let me set the scene. This incident happened a little over a year ago, but my friends who were accompanying me that fateful day make sure now and again that I don't forget about it. This all happened in my local language, but I have tried to translate it to English to the best of my abilities. The scene here is the local McDonald's fast food place nearby my university. I had dressed up that day in a bright yellow polo shirt with my university logo embroidered on it, which was provided to me by my uni, but wasn't an official uniform that we were required to wear. I had unfortunately chosen to combine that shirt with a pair of black trousers with formal office shoes to boot because I had to present my final project of my final year in a conference. Fast forward to afternoon, after bossing the conference all morning, me and my groupmates decided to head to McDonald's to celebrate. All in all, it was turning out to be a great day, or so I had thought. We placed our orders at the counter and seated ourselves down in a suitable place. Now, there wasn't really anybody there at that time apart from this young couple. They were probably in their late 20s if I recall correctly, and two other groups who had also decided to grab some lunch perhaps. Me being the super hygiene conscious dude of the group, decided to go wash my hands properly at the sink near the restroom. As I was heading back, I passed the young couple when I heard a voice go, "Hey you, here please." It was the lady who was beckoning me to their table. So I stupidly decided to find out what her problem was. "I was calling out for such a long time, no one seemed to care. This is just ridiculous, I tell you." I was confused. The man, whom I assumed was her husband, just sat there with a mortified look on his face. She continued,
Now, can we please get a bottle of mineral water and some napkins?
Ma'am, I am sorry, but I don't work here. I'm not an employee, I said calmly. Now, if this was any regular restaurant, I would understand her confusion. However, all fast food places in my country except Pizza Hut are self-service. Moreover, while my attire seemed similar to the one worn by actual employees, my shirt was completely yellow with no pockets, while theirs was yellow with a red collar and a red pocket with the McDonald's logo on it. I tried to explain this to the lady, who looked very annoyed and pointed to the counter and said they would be happy to help her. Thankfully, her presumed husband was an understanding man and tried to reason with her, but she was having none of that. She said in an assertive tone, "I have been coming to this place since I was in insert university name. I know everybody here, the manager too. I will complain about you at the counter." Turning to her husband, "These new people don't even have the decency to speak properly to the customer." I was even more confused, and the man was petrified. Hearing all the commotion, the lady taking orders at the counter came out to see what was wrong. Thankfully, she was glad to serve her, mind you, in a self-service food chain, and I returned to my friends after making a hash of things. They obviously laughed at my expense after I had told them what happened. Nowadays, I just laugh when I recall this incident and hope I can gather the strength to remain as cool as I did that day in similar situations. I just think if you threaten going to their boss to get them fired from whatever position, make sure they actually do work there. And our final story of the day is by MoIsMe6277, Wrong Convenience Store. I work at Racetrack. A couple of months ago, after I got off work, I had to stop at Kroger. I realized I'd forgotten to pick up something while I was at work, and I didn't want to go back into Kroger because I already had someone try to ask me a question about a product in there. Because apparently, if you're wearing a work uniform, no matter where from, you work at whatever store you're in, even though Kroger doesn't even do uniforms anymore. Luckily, I just stopped the person and said, "I'm sorry, I don't work here." And they immediately apologized and continued their search for an employee, but I've already been through the going through a grocery store in my work uniform situation of mistaken employee identity a couple years ago with 3 people in the same store, and didn't want to go through that again. I was tired and wanted to go home. There was a quick trip right outside of Kroger. QT and Racetrack are basically the same store, with a slightly different layout and a different name, and they carry the same things. So I knew QT would have what I was looking for. As soon as I stepped in, one of the employees rolled her eyes at me and said, "Another new hire?" I looked behind me to see if maybe a QT employee was behind me. Nope, just me. I continued on. I get my things and head up to the counter. The same QT employee looks annoyed with me and says, "You can't ring things up until after shift. But since you haven't clocked in yet, I can go ahead and ring them up. Have they shown you how to clock in yet? Go ahead and do that and I'll ring this up." I said, "I don't work here." She looked at my name tag. I felt like I was going through deja vu at this point, which said Racetrack right above my name and said, "That looks like our uniform and our name tags." Their uniforms are a red polo with, I think, khakis and a circular name tag that has the QT square logo at the top. Racetrack's uniforms are a blue polo with black pants. We can wear khakis too, but I always choose to wear black pants. A rectangular name tag with Racetrack in big letters at the top. I was also wearing my Racetrack cap. I said, "No, it doesn't. I work at Racetrack and this is a Racetrack uniform." She looked at my uniform again, then looked at her own and slaps her forehead and says, "Sorry, I used to work at Racetrack until last month." All I could say was, "Is the pay better here?" Wow, these two drastically different uniforms look exactly identical. It's exactly what we... Oh, wait, no, it's not. But with that being said, that's all the time we have for today. So, which of these stories was your favorite and why? Let me know in the comments down below. But besides that, if you enjoyed the video, please consider liking and subscribing and turn notifications on if you haven't so you'll never miss an upcoming video. Any little thing that you do helps the channel grow so much more. Whether it's commenting, subscribing, or just watching the video, thank you all so very much for supporting me right here on the Storytime channel.
I hope you all have a wonderful day, and I'll see you all next time, right here.